I went to Hillcrest Middle School, as shown by these two pictures here. I didn't have a lot of friends because I was separated from the friends I made in elementary school. They just didn't want to talk to me anymore. You know, I showed it by these two pictures here. And it left me feeling like this picture, a sad face. I didn't really go out of my way to make new friends, though, because I was shy and withdrawn. In grade 7, I made a few new friends, all of which are people I still talk to today. And in grade 8, it pretty much stayed those few friends. I think the biggest reason I was so shy, though, was because I didn't have a job. I didn't really have the money to kind of deepen those friendships, like any new friendships I did make, as shown by this picture here, the kid with no money and funds for the week, because that's pretty much how I was living. I never got placed outside of my comfort zone, and I didn't have a reason to get placed outside of my comfort zone, because I just didn't interact with people. And at this point in my life, I wasn't jaded by a soul-crushing retail job. As a result of not having a whole lot of friends, I tended to do activities that required you to be alone, such as playing video games like Fallout, League of Legends, and Hearthstone. I also watched a lot of anime. My favorites were Fullmetal Alchemist and Cowboy Bebop, both of which are super edgy, which is kind of reflected on how I was back then. And I really like comedians like Bo Burnham, whose humor is both cynical and dark, which again reflects on how I was, because if I did make friends, they were off put by how edgy I was. God, what a mistake. Memories made in the coldest winter. Goodbye, my friend. Will I ever love again? Today, though, everything's good. I do have friends. As shown by this picture here, where we all took a picture on National Easy Day. And right here is a picture of me in grade 9 at a friend's birthday party. I put a $50 bill here instead of a $100 bill to show that though I do have a job now, it is just a wage slave job. So I have money, but like a moderate amount, not in excess. And then this was kind of to show my routine where I don't have school, which consists of eating at Shobu Ramen, going to sleep, going to Reclaiming and Superstore, and then repeating that. And that's my life. I go to Charles Best Secondary School, obviously. I'm in English. I don't like French. And I'm feeling pretty happy every day. You know, every day is a new day. I'm okay with talking to people. I'm okay with being outside of my comfort zone because I have a job where I'm forced to do that, and I'm jaded by that job. So, you know, nothing really makes me angry anymore because I've been through that from old white mothers. Anime and manga still play a really big part of my life, same as games. I still do these activities very frequently. I just, you know, don't talk about it, and I've seen my social status rise as a result. But I still do these in my free time. Some of my favorites here are Haruhi Suzumiya, which is just about a girl who unknowingly is God. Right here is Great Teacher Onizuka, which is both an anime and a manga, and has been a big inspiration in my life. I have the book right here. Oyasumi Punpun, which is about a young man who comes from a shattered home, and it just has him as he ages, and it's his shattered family relationship, how it affects his view of relationships and how he grows up and his interactions with people. I have the book right here. Oyasumi means good night in Japanese. League of Legends, I still play very frequently with my friends. It's one of the few activities we can still do together. Just because of school. Welcome to the NHK is about a shut-in who struggles to get back into the real world, and he soon learns that his only romantic interest is only interested in him because she sees him as less pathetic, or more pathetic than she is, and so she can, and so she is with him for that main reason, so she can feel better about it. Monogatari, right here, is based off of, French New Wave, and it's very experimental, and it's mainly dialogue driven. I have one of the books right here. K-On! Here is about a group of girls who create a band against all odds. I have that here as well. Anohana is about a group of childhood friends who get displaced from each other due to a childhood event where one of their friends dies. And then one of them can see her as a ghost, and it's really sad. Toradora here, it's just a generic romance, which is kind of nice. This is from Clannad, it's a romance about sort of a punk who
grows as a person, starts a family, and his wife dies, and then his daughter dies. It's kind of sad. And then Serial Experiments Lane is just a really experimental anime about a girl who is unknowingly a part of a computer simulation, and her entire life is a sham. Anyway, like I said, all of these I still consume just constantly, just every single day. I'm sure many people cited music as some of their interests, if they decided to do an interest slide. For me, some of my favorite albums are Joy Division's Unknown Pleasures, Kanye West's The College Dropout, Hatsune Miku, Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness by the Smashing Pumpkins, and Meat is Murder by the Smiths. Each of these albums speak to me on very different ways. Joy Division's Unknown Pleasures has a lot of very good songs and tells the story of Ian Curtis, who is the lead singer, or was the lead singer of Joy Division. Unfortunately, he died in 1981. A lot of the songs tell about his struggles with depression, anxiety, and epilepsy. It was made by Ian and his friends, and all of which did not know how to play their respective instruments. I think it's, even though, you know, the band didn't expect it to be a success at all, I think it was an amazing album, just a complete masterpiece. The songs are all extremely bleak and sound unlike anything I've ever heard from a different artist. The song New Dawn Fades specifically is about Curtis and it's basically a suicide note talking about how he's unhappy with the life he lives, being a civil servant in the UK. One of my other favorite albums is Kanye West's The College Dropout. And since this album, Kanye West hasn't done anything like it. It's very down to earth and speaks of Kanye's something to nothing, or from nothing to something story. It speaks of him loving his mother and just generally his family, especially the song Family Business, speaking about back when he was a kid and his experiences with his family. Kanye actually wrote one of the most successful songs, Through the Wire, while his mouth was wired shut after a car accident. The songs are all very inspirational, like Last Call, which is the final song of the album, and it talks about how nobody wanted to sign Kanye West, and despite the fact that he was against all odds, he succeeded in the end and became who he is today. Hatsune Miku's music is just really nice. Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness is an album by Smashing Pumpkins. All the songs are written by Billy Corgan, who is the lead singer. Billy himself has a terrible voice, but he makes it work in all the songs. A lot of the music tells of his depression and how he was unhappy with the life he was living. He wanted to become a rock star, but no one believed he could because of how terrible his voice was. But in the end, it all worked out for him, just like it did with Kanye. The Smiths' Meat is Murder is the Smiths' greatest album, in my opinion. Some of the songs, like I Want the One I Can't Have, are about Morrissey's ambiguous sexuality and how he became comfortable with who he is while still struggling with the idea of who he is. Kind of a weird dynamic he has there. Everybody has their own form of expression. For some, it's painting. For some, it's painting and making art. Whether it be drawing, music, or, you know, making videos. For me, though, it's fashion. I chose an outfit here that really is interesting to me because it's that sort of nouveau goth slash funeral hipster kind of look. Some of my favorite brands are Rick Owens, designed by Rick Owens himself, who, instead of relying on graphics to design, he uses interesting symmetry with clothing and silhouettes. He uses the more black and white style and is inspired by bands such as The Ramones, Kiss, and David Bowie, that kind of look. He's a punk designer. Same as Raph Simmons, who's a Belgian designer, who is inspired by the punk culture, such as the Sex Pistols, Bowie, and, you know, various other punk bands. He's very much a youth culture designer, and he started all the way back in the 90s. Another one of my favorite designers is Takahiro Miyashita, who's designed for the brand Number 9, a personal favorite of mine, and the brand Takahiro Miyashita the Soloist. And he's inspired by the punk culture, but the punk culture he's inspired by is different from the two of them, and it's more of the Cobain style, where it's very grunge-like. He relies on graphic tees and sort of the Cobain wardrobe, which he actually did a collection based off of. He's very much a fan of Americana. And I'm also inspired by Kanye West and his fashion, because Kanye West, nobody believed he can start a brand, but he did it anyway. And even though his brand does kind of rip off Rick Owens a bit, he goes for more of a military look. more beige sand type colors. And right here is just a silhouette of a shoe by Rick Owens I like, which is inspired by Johnny Ramone of the punk band the Ramones. Johnny Ramone used to wear high top Converses, and so Rick Owens kind of took that and made them of leather. In the foreseeable future, I'll be attending SFU in the fall. I've already been accepted for the Department of Sciences, where I'll be studying chemistry. This is a Lewis dot diagram I have here of caffeine, which is a student's best friend. Chemistry has always really spoken to me. It all started back when I watched Full Metal Alchemist, and they talk about the sort of chemical buildup of a human, and that was a completely foreign idea to me, and it amazed me that humans are made of tiny little molecules. And so I decided to study it, and I took it a year early in Best. And I really liked the course, whether it be, because I had a good teacher or because it's generally an interesting course. And so I took Chem 12 a year earlier, and I pre-tutor it this year. And again, just amazing course, just super fascinating concepts. That being said, though, my main goal is to become an English teacher in Japan, which doesn't require me to study English in post-secondary. I just need to get a four-year degree. And that kind of came to me after I read a book called Great Teacher Onizuka, which is just about a guy who's a teacher, which, seems like a very boring concept, but it again spoke to me. And so, my parents often ask me what I'll do if I can't go to Japan. And I usually joke with them and say, oh,
Standing up, and I'm telling you, I am Warhol. I am the number one most impactful artist of our generation. I am Shakespeare in the flesh. Walt Disney, Nike, Google. Now, who's gonna be the Medici family and stand up and let me create more?
I think that everybody should be inspired by somebody, and for me, that person I'm inspired by is Kanye West. Kanye West oozes charisma. He's the kind of person who will believe in himself so much that everything he does is great, that he'll just produce great things, and his music's pretty much an example of that. Another inspiration of mine is Ian Curtis of Joy Division, who's just a wordsmith, and it's just amazing with his words, and his lyrics of his songs are just, they're so interesting, and he often talks about his own struggles with depression and anxiety, and often the songs will, be a little grim, but they're great songs nonetheless. Same with Kurt Cobain, the lead singer of Nirvana, who unfortunately killed himself, same as Ian Curtis. But again, his music's super inspirational, and his story of kind of just being a dropout who got really lucky is just amazing to me. And now all these artists here, aside from Kanye, are inspired by one man, and that one man is David Bowie. Bowie's music is revolutionary. And with every new album he created, he inspired new ways of people, because everything he did was extremely experimental, and Bowie was never afraid to be himself, a sort of glam rock artist in a very, conservative world at the time. And finally, one of my biggest inspirations is, like I said, Rick Owens, who's an American designer who is similar to me, half Spanish and half English, or white, sorry. And his ability just to create for himself, like everything he makes is something that he'd wear himself, and that's amazing to me. Just being able to create things like that is just so crazy. I look up to him immensely for just his ability to be so creative. Like all these people here, they're all just so creative and have so much self-confidence. It's amazing to me. Now, some of the things I aspire for. Obviously, as I said, I aspire to go to Japan to become an English teacher, simply because, one, the culture, it just fascinates me completely, and I really like the language, probably from, like 6 years of being conditioned to like it, more or less. And these, right here is GTO, a teacher who's just, everything he does is inspirational, and he kind of taught me that a teacher isn't just someone who teaches, but as someone who looks out for their students, and it goes above and beyond. These two things here are just two pieces of clothing that I really like. This is a Rick Owens dunk, which was discontinued after he got a cease and desist from Nike for this here resembling the Nike swoosh. It's really hard to find, and honestly, it's just a really nice shoe. Right here is a Riot 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 Bomber by Raph Simmons. It has pictures of David Bowie on it, who's one of my inspirations and favorite musical artists. It's another hard piece to find because it was made in 2001, which is before I was even born. And it's just something I'd hope to have after I've established a career for myself. Thank you for watching this far. After this, I'll have just a slideshow of things I went through during high school with my friends. This part doesn't have a script, so I'm just kind of rambling right now. I'm ending it off with a little quote here. I'll just read it out. People like us aren't qualified to be involved in a dramatic incident such as a suicide. No matter how depressed you are or how much pain you're in, you have to return to your routine daily life. Even if you don't come back, you'll just end up dying in vain. A dramatic death is befitting of us. Thank you very much.
Suicide if you ever try to let go. I'm sad, I know, yeah. I'm sad, I know, yeah. Who am I? Someone that's afraid to let go. You decide if you ever gonna let me know. Yeah. Suicide if you ever try to let go. I'm sad, I know, yeah. I'm sad, I know, yeah. I gave her everything. She took my heart and left me lonely. I think broken hearts contentious. I won't fix, I'd rather weep. I'm lost and I'm found, but it's torture being in love. I love when you're around, but I fucking hate when you leave. Who am I? Someone that's afraid to let go. You decide if you're ever gonna let me know. Yeah, suicide if you ever try to let go. I'm sad, I know, yeah. I'm sad, I know, yeah. Who am I? Someone that's afraid to let go. Suicide if you ever gonna let me know. Yeah, suicide if you ever try to let go. I'm sad, I know, yeah. I'm sad, I know, yeah. That's afraid to let go. You decide if you're ever gonna let me know. Yeah, suicide if you ever try to let go. I'm sad, I know, yeah. I'm sad, I know, yeah. Who am I? Someone that's afraid to let go. You decide if you're ever gonna let me know. Yeah, suicide if you ever try to let go. I'm sad, I know, yeah. I'm sad, I know.